What up though? DJ Star back with another On Feet video, and today we're discussing one of, well, not necessarily one of my favorite silhouettes, but we'll be discussing the Air Jordan 10. But before we do that, please take the time out to subscribe to the channel, like the videos, and hit that notification bell so you'll be alerted when I drop new content. It helps the channel grow and it goes a long way. And as long as it takes me to explain it, you could have probably already did it. So with that being said, we're going to go over the Air Jordan 10. Now, this shoe released in January 127, 2018 for retail price of $190. It is currently reselling on StockX for $350. So I'm like, wow, because when these came out, these set, nobody was fooling with them like that. And they set for a little minute. Even my plug, when he got them to me, he was like, man, yeah, I'm cool, man. I'm going to super hard pass on those. I'm like, yeah, I love it. But then you can sell them on StockX for $190. The retail was $190. So by the time you did that, you actually lost money. So again, shoes are stock. So let's go over this. Now, what made me grab, I'm not a big, big fan of the Air Jordan 10, but what made me grab it, and it's not the silhouette, but what made me grab these is because of the colorway. That cool gray colorway is just so dope to me. I don't care really what it's on. I just grab it. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to the cool gray, I'm just on it. I don't know what it is about cool gray, but it's just so live to me. So I had to grab the shoe. One thing that makes me not a fan of the Air Jordan 10 is the lacing system. So it's not so much the lacing system in itself, because it's a speed lace, but it's the bands in between, and it just makes it super tight on my feet. Now this shoe, of course, is designed for performance, so you want to be locked in, you want to be tight and snug, you don't want to have roll in your feet when you're playing. So I understood the band system, but it's just so damn tight on my feet. So a lot of times I can wear them, but I can't be in these like hours. I could be in these 2 hours max, but anything more than that, I'm ready to change them, because the top of it just hugs my feet so tight, and I don't like that feeling. But as you see, it's a cool gray colorway. You got cool gray all the way up to the tongue. You got your Air Jordan 23 on the tongue, and this leather on here is a synthetic leather. It's not real at all. The leather that wraps around here, around the speed laces, is also synthetic, so not no leather on this shoe at all, but it's still, the cool gray colorway is dope. Behind it, you got the Air Jordan, the classic 90s type style with the, you know, all the colors and stuff behind the tongue, which is a dope touch by Tinker. I can't sit here in front on that. When you go to the lateral side of the shoe, you'll see again, it's all gray, all in the cool gray colorway. This is like Durabuck, so it's real smooth. It's a nice soft material. Well, it's not really all that soft. It's okay. It does have give in it, but it's just a clean look in the colorway all the way around. Your midsole to your outsole is all done in cool gray all the way around, synthetic pieces. And then you can see the color sticking out from your outsole, and we'll describe that in a minute. Your ankle collar right here is also made of a synthetic, but what I do like about them is that they're so low. Right here, they dip down so low, so it's comfortable and easy to get into, and that's what made me like the, that's the best part I like about the 10, other than the outsole. So when you get to the medial side, you'll see the same thing, just all cool gray construction, your synthetics up here, your Durabuck right here, and then you got like a plastic piece right here, which is your midsole, or rubber, shall I say. I want to say it's Phylon, midsole, and you got down here your outsole in cool gray with the different colors. When you go around to the heel of the shoe, you also see that they got a Jumpman on it with a pull tab. Some pull tabs have designs on them, most of the basic ones didn't. And then you got your Jumpman right there done, and a smooth, cool gray colorway matches right with the shoe. I really wasn't mad at that at all. I'm not gonna say it's a cool touch. I mean, yeah, it's a dope touch. I'm not gonna sit here in front. And some Air Jordan 10s, you do have Jordan numbers stitched in here, 23 or 45, depending on what number he was wearing when he returned back. Because if you remember, the year these were released, he came back to basketball like 17 games. It was like 17 or 18 games left in the season when he came back. And this is before the Air Jordan 11 Concord was ready. So he wore these to hoop in when he came back to the Chicago Bulls. So you'll get some with the 23, some with the 45. But to be honest with you, this is the only Air Jordan 10 that's in my collection. I did enjoy the city pack, but this is the basic upper with the other colors. It's like I wanted more. And I really grabbed these because of the cool gray colorway. So in the other ones, I really wanted more. I thought about going back and getting the Bulls over Broadway, but I just didn't want to pay the money for it. And I also thought about getting the cement ones that was all cement all over. But I was just like, I don't know. Too much cement kind of looks odd to me. But other than that, we get to the last part of the shoe. Then you get the outsole. Now, the outsole was unique for the purpose of, as you can see, Tinker Hatfield put all of Jordan's accomplishments at the bottom of the shoe at the time. You know, of course he had more, but he took the best ones that he thought of and put them on the bottom of the shoe. And that made it dope. These are done in a cool gray colorway, but with multicolors in between on the lace, the bottom of the sole where his accomplishments are. So I just thought that was a cool touch in itself. Not cool, a big fan of multicolor, but the way it looked with the cool gray, I just thought that was dope. As far as the traction go, last time I played in these, man, I mean, I played outside, so if you're outside on concrete, you should be pretty good. But if you're gonna be in the gym, you might have an issue because it's not a whole lot of traction on here. Even the little grooves don't give a whole lot when you're playing ball. So maybe that's why Jordan really only wore the shoe just a little bit when he came back until the 11 was done with that herringbone traction. As far as the unit goes, I want to say it's Zoom Air in the heel and the forefront. I'm not exactly sure because I literally only own this pair of the Air Jordan 10. I have no more. So I'll look it up and I'll post it in the video when I post it what kind of air was in the Air Jordan 10. I don't believe it's a shank plate either. I just think it's just an air unit in the heel and it's one in the forefront. In the heel, sometimes when I put them on, I can feel it. Don't feel it so much in the forefront. But that's about it for this video. So again, we have an Air Jordan 10 cool gray. Like I said, I'm a big fan of cool gray, not so much a big fan of the Air Jordan 10. With that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here, but I will appreciate it if you do subscribe to the channel, DJ Star C. Like the videos, comment down below, and hit that notification bell, and we're all good. So with that being said, I'm gonna get up out of here. As always, love, peace, and prosperity. I'm gone.